Hello, everybody! Hello, my name is Paul, and I have a gravelly voice. Hello, everybody! Hello, my name is Paul. Welcome, one and all. Welcome back to Leisure Suit Larry 3, where we are on the very cusp of currying Patty's favor. She's, well, canonically, she's the one we're supposed to end up with, and the game lets you know it. The game lets you know, it's like, look, you've been wooing all these other girls, but they really don't matter. I'm the final boss of this game, is what Patty's telling me. So, well, let's just proceed. I remember already giving her the lay, at least I thought I did. No, wait. She didn't take it because I was still technically, at least into her mind, married. But now that we're not married anymore...
Patty, please wear my lay tonight for me alone.
And her mouth just kind of morphs into, I don't know what kind of expression that is.
Oh, Larry, thank you. You're such a charmer. I'm ready. What do you want to do?
How do I play this in character? Or, look, let's just go to your place.
Oh, well, what the hell? It's getting late. I'm ready to quit for the night, and you're looking better all the time. Sure, let's go.
She must have been drinking.
Here, Larry, take the key to my suite, says Patty. I'll slip out of the back way and use the service elevator. Just wait a few minutes before you come upstairs, and I'd like to slip into something more comfortable. Like your flowers.
And remember, Larry, I refuse to make love to a man without something to drink first.
No offense, of course.
She's done this before. All right, none taken, you suppose. All right, well, before we even head up to the penthouse, let's work our way down and find some booze. Well, not just any booze. I mean, this is Patty. She's a classy dame, even though she's agreeing to sleep with me for flowers and wine. Now, there's really only one bar that I could think of in the entire game, which was the comedy club, and I think... there it is. The bottle of wine just mysteriously appears on our table, and we can take it.
A bottle of wine rests on the center table, breathing until its owner returns with bated breath, I'm sure.
Well, mine now. I wonder if we can actually sit down and watch another show.
You blindly cop some poor slob's bottle of fine wine.
I'm going to save and then see if we can watch the show again. Let's see if it does it. Oh, God, you can. Nope, let me out. All right, Patty, here we go. We've got everything we need. We are dressed and buffed for success. Oh, come on, in the name of realism. Well, at least they both come down. Better than most hotels I've been to. Oh! Elevator party.
Let's see, go. That's probably push penthouse, I'd imagine. There we go.
You insert Patty's penthouse key to the 9th floor penthouse access a lock. Turn it 1/4 to the right. Both you and the elevator begin to rise. See, with the happy music and like, oh, it's triumphant. Oh, yeah, we're going to win the game. Woo. And technically, you should win the game at this point. It's like, hey, yeah, you met Patty. Everything's great. You're going to fall in love. But no, the game doesn't do that. The game keeps going.
I remember to bring the wine, Patty.
And Larry, I remember to wear your lei.
Oh, my. This is so wonderfully 90s. And she has another piano in her penthouse. This is a really nice place, even though the island is fairly polluted and everything. But at least from up here, you can't tell. Pour the wine, brother.
You decide to place the bottle of wine on the silver tray resting at the table at the foot of the circular bed beside the two glasses Patty has thoughtfully provided for the occasion.
Oh, I can actually skip this whole scene. Oh, the music sounds different. Dun, dun, dun.
Perhaps I should explain. I have a history of not being able to finish text boxes. But, never mind.
Rest assured, honey. I promise you, something will happen.
We're gonna have some wine? Would you care for a glass of wine?
I thought you'd never ask.
This is really awkward.
Say when?
Just go all the way.
Right after this drink, Larry.
Well, at least she lays everything out in black and white. Like, you know exactly, there's no ambiguousness with Patty. There you go.
And just, toss your cups and just give in to the passion. Come on, guys. Now, you're just drawing this out now.
So, Patty, how did you get started in the music business?
This is probably where Patty says, shut up, and yeah, there we go. Well, see, the implied romance of this scene...
Oh, Patty!
The implied romance of this scene is kind of undercut by the way that we pretty much just gave her presents in exchange for sex. Now, where'd you learn to kiss like that?
Well, when I was younger, I did play trumpet in a mariachi band.
There we go, Larry. Take the initiative. We'll see you later, buddy. Are we gonna get, like, the classic fireworks? Oh, Larry. Like, the train entering the tunnels back and forth, rockets taking off, bridges collapsing, you know, that sort of thing. Ooh-ah. Yes, are you guys as turned on as I am? Forgive me for not voice acting these parts, but this is a little... this is weird. So Larry essentially is Podrick here. He's just sort of got, well, Larry, perhaps you learn more from Kalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalal really awkward.
Oh, Larry. And you think to yourself, how ironic. Of all both the women I've known, this piano player turned out to be the greatest.
What's so ironic about that? I don't quite get the irony. Where's the black fly in this Chardonnay?
How ironic. Of all the men I've had, this dork turns out to be the greatest.
Oh, the nice guy wins. Don your fedora, Larry. Take to the internet. Let the weeple know. Simultaneously, you murmur into the other's ear,
I never knew it could be this good.
Yes!
And blarg. Time for a nap. As Patty drifts off into sleep, you realize this is one woman who deserves her nickname.
The woman of my dreams. The man of my dreams.
I'm in love.
There'll never be another woman for me. How I wish I still smoked.
The two of you drift off to sleep, bathed in the glow of your experience together.
That settles it. From now on, it's Larry Laffer forever. Tomorrow, I must call my boyfriend and tell him I'm breaking off our relationship for good. Sorry, Arnold.
As she falls asleep, thinking about how she'll handle the end of her other relationship, Patty murmurs softly a single devastating word. Arnold.
What? What did you say? Arnold? Arnold? Oh no. I thought she felt something. I know I felt it. During the best sexual experience of my life, she was thinking of another man? I'm so stupid. By now I should have learned. Some men have a way with women, and some don't. I was a fool to believe my new body would make a difference. Nothing makes any difference. Once you're a loser, you're always a loser. I give up. I've had it with women. This is not worth it. I'm going where no woman will ever frustrate me again.
He's gone. What happened? Where could he be? Oh no. I finally meet the man of my dreams and now he vanishes into thin air. Now what will I do? Where is he? He's gone. He's really gone. Where could he go at this time of night? Why would he leave? Am I blind? How could I let him slip through my fingers?
Whoop!
What was that? Off in the distance, way over there, at that point. Was that a flash of white polyester?
It's him!
Oh, poor Larry. Looks like he's wandering off into the jungle, never to be seen again. Oh,
but where is he going? There's nothing that way but uncharted bamboo forest. He's gone. But it had to be Larry. His pulsating pectorals are recognizable anywhere.
Suddenly, everything seems so obvious, so simple. I must give up everything and find my man. I know my quest to find Larry Laffer.
That's right, Patty. We're off on a quest now. There we go, and now we have possession of polyester. No, not polyester Patty. It used to be polyester Patty, but now it's passionate Patty. Because I don't think she actually dons any polyester at all. Unless that's what her sheets are made of. Speaking of, we have to go out on a rescue mission. But first, we need to dress the part.
Oh, so change isn't good enough for you, huh? Okay, fine.
There we go. Patty, you've got... that is just blatant... what is it? Product placement. Do they even still make legs anymore? Whoop, there they are, gone. All right, and then I guess the dress would be next, or does it have to be? Oh, well, I'm wearing hose and high heels, but still wearing my blanket. All right, fine. Modesty, Patty, modesty.
You slide your dress over the screen and drop the sheet to the floor.
There we go. Now we're ready. What else can we take with us? Let's get the wine. If we're gonna go on a jungle adventure, we're gonna need to be prepared for everything. What else can I take? Tray. Can I take that? No, room service will get it. Well, we're feeling a little depressed. Let's get ourselves cheered up. Let's play a couple sad piano tunes.
You consider fighting your depressed feeling with music, but instead realize finding Larry Laffer is the only medicine you need.
So now we have to work our way all the way across the island, which doesn't take that long, really. And get to the uncharted bamboo forest. But first, there's a couple things we have to do. We have to find some hints. We got to know what we are doing and prepare ourselves for a survival journey thing.
So now, as Patty, I don't think that much changes. We're sort of like in the second half of the game, maybe like the last third, maybe.
But let's look around and see what's changed. Let's see what we can interact with that Larry could not, or see if anything's changed. Maitre D' is gone. I wonder if this door is still unlocked. Can Patty get back here?
Nope, it's locked. All right, fine. All right, how about the piano bar? Oh, wait, I can get my tips. Yeah, the tips are mine. Gonna need this money. Get tips.
You keep your tip jar above the treble end of your keyboard.
Yes, I know. Well, take tips?
Let's see, did we have a good night tonight? Oh well, a few bucks is better than nothing. Where you're going, you're not going to need a lot of money anyway. And it's kind of hard to miss, but we passed by this little multicolored chalkboard thing. But now the pen is there. You see that little glowing thing? Yeah, we need that. Why, look, someone left the marking pen laying in the tray of the announcement board. Well, let's get that. Great! A magic marker. A girl never knows when she might need a little magic in her life. Now, speaking of, let's see what we have in our inventory here. So we have our tips. Feed the kitty. I think it's just another way of saying tip me. Let's see. We have our key. Empty bottle. I should probably fill that with water before we go. Our pantyhose. Our dress. And the magic marker. I don't think that really prepares us for survival situations out in the jungle, but it's a start. But now I know there's one place that Patty can go that Larry could not just because it was closed. And that was the other bar in town. Actually, before we go there, she mentioned she knows the guy at Fat City. So let's see if there's a scene between Patty and what's his face? Oh, of course he's gone. Lazy. There we go. Oh, and it's open now. Hey, the maitre d' kind of moonlight says a bouncer, does he?
Hello, sir. Could you give me some information about the show inside?
Tonight's show is offered at the special low rate of only $25. Of course, with tax, that will come to $42.95 exactly.
Well, do I have enough money for that?
Here's all the money I have in the world, you say to the doorman. Boy, what luck. Just happens to have $43 in tips.
Why, thank you very much, ma'am. I know you'll enjoy the show. Thank you.
Oh, we got this cool little top-down perspective. Love it. What a nasty establishment this is. You love it. All right, well, let's have a seat. Do it. The chair faces not only the wrong way, but has a reserved sign on it. The part of the chair side is occupied. Okay. Oh, that's right. I know why. That'll be important later. Sit. Oh, for God's sake. On with the show that will never start until I sit down.
Ladies and ladies, Chip and Dale's is proud to present in person tonight only for one show only. The first, the original, the greatest, the owner, Dale.
Yay. Oh, this is actually one of my favorite tunes in the game. Oh, that shadow is so weird. All right, bring it on. Whee! Chippendales! Woo! Hey, that's for me. Get shirt. Oh, I can't get it. Okay, fine. Oh, my. Oh, yeah. Wiggle it, wiggle it, wiggle it. Let's see. Cheer! You applaud uproariously. Oh, yeah, there's actually animated. Let's see. I think this is how this works. I think you're supposed to throw your panties at him because, like, it's a Tom Jones show. Let's see. Take off. Oh, I might be wrong about this. An excellent idea, but what would you do with them? Throw panties on stage. I don't have... how do we do this?
All right, ladies, let's really hear it for him. Isn't he wonderful?
I can't figure out what the game wants me to do. I know what I need to do, but I'm fighting the parser system. All right, well, that's... that's pretty much game over. Dale doesn't want his shirt back. We need to talk to Dale, but he doesn't know that we're here, so... oh, there it is. Oh, he does. Okay. Talk. Hey, Dale? 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 Come back! Oh, he's gone. All right, that was just a mess. Let's try that again. Oh, there's even a hint if you look at him. It's like, wow, he looks exactly like a young Tom Jones. The women here are going wild. The men look terminally bored. All right, there's that. Okay. So, I think throw panties was enough. I thought I tried this, but let's try something more specific. How do I do it? Oh, wait, did I not get dressed when I was up there? Oh, crap. Hang on. I rejoin you rather perplexed, because now we're back here in Patty's room after having to watch that scene over, like, five times, because I forgot to save, like, five times. So here's our choice of clothing here. So we have pantyhose and we have a dress, obviously. So we look clothes. So that's how it says. His hose and the gown. Right, big deal. But, like, where is everything else? Because we need to pick up our other undergarments, but I can't find anything. Like, look behind screen, maybe? No, nothing. There's nothing pointing out that you actually need undergarments at all. You just have to kind of know. So if you type get panties, there we go. And apparently there's a bra back there somewhere too. I didn't see them. The game doesn't point them out to me. Whatever. That's really annoying because those are two game overs if you miss that. Because once you're in the club, when you leave, that's it. You can't get back in. The show's over. You're done. Deal. Dead woman walking. All right. So now, properly supported and all, I think we're ready to get this going. I'm surprised it didn't have to remind me to put on my flippin' shoes. And also, before we head to the bar, I might as well go ahead and fill up our water jug now, because I'm not sure if he passed by this way again. You place your bottle under the tap while carefully considering the level of carcinogenic compounds therein. Oh god, the water's brown. Dealio, okay, now we're ready to go. Bottle of water and fully dressed, let's roll. Alright, now we're gonna do this right. Oh, for crying out loud. Throw panties at the guy next to me, just do it. Flat. You slip off your Saturday night specials and readjust your pantyhose all in one smooth moment. Movement? Yeah, something like that. There we go. Do it, Patty. Hey, Dale, these are for you. You shriek, take me, big boy, I'm yours. Yeah, getting over the loss of the love of your life there, Patty. On a mission to find Larry, are we? All right, well, whatever. Okay, so now we wait, and now Dale, instead of just walking out of the club, should come over and say hello.
Any minute now. There he comes.
Patty, look! It's him! Dale! He's here walking through the audience.
Oh, he just... Well, oh, thank God.
Hey, was that you that threw the lovely pair of panties at me, wasn't it? You look lonely. Would you like a little company?
Yeah, sure.
Hi, handsome. My name is Patty, but you can call me Passionate.
Thanks, Patty. And you may call me Dale.
Whoa! That's... This is like 1990s male ideal, is it? He looks like Bob Vila with chubby little Santa Claus cheeks. Pinch cheeks.
The hell are you saying?
Stroke beard. Oh, the sexiest men have beards. That's right. Pay attention, boys. See box cover. Hello. Before you sits Dale the male stripper, the co-owner of Chip and Dale's. You hope he may be able to help you find Larry.
Hey, sure. Hello.
All right, talk Dale. So, yeah, this is exactly what you want to talk to a male stripper about. There's so many other people in town you can talk to.
So, Dale, is there any way through that treacherous bamboo forest that lies in the north of the village?
Why are you asking me this? Patty, all I can say is, when all else fails, read your manual.
Read manual. It's the box your discs came in. Have you read it? All right. Let's talk to him some more. Can I talk anymore? No, that's all he has to say. He just says, hey, look at your manual, dick. Well, no. Look at your manual. Never mind. Why do I have a feeling that Al Lowe's kind of putting himself into this? I wonder if this is modeled off a young Al Lowe with hair.
You stare deeply into his eyes. You see no signs of life.
What is going on? What is with this guy? Nook nose. He has a nice rhythm to his breathing.
Dale's ears are not what attracted you to him.
Look, penis. What do you think of this, Dale? What? What?
Oh, it's true. You are the passionate one.
What did I just do? Dale, I gotta go. Been a pleasure talking to you, Dale. Bye.
Stop smiling at me. Hope you get your man, Patty.
I think that actually is supposed to be like a young Al Lowe. I wonder if that's what he looked like back in his heyday. And he's just going to sit with me forever wearing his little thong. All right, look at the box, eh? All right, so here we are back at the manual. And I think I sort of kind of know what we need to be looking for.
So it boils down to north, north, east, east, northwest, northeast, north, north, northwest, west, south, northwest, north, northwest, north, and then you're done. So let's
go do that. This part kind of reminds me, come on, Patty, let's go. We got stuff to do. This part, in a weird way, reminds me a little bit about, what was it, Hugo 2, I think, where you're playing the role of a Penelope. And you have to navigate this maze, and it's a very similar type of thing. But here, we have to worry about our water intake, and it's really weird. You'll see as we move along. Here's the bamboo jungle. Let's not put it off any longer. Ugh, copy protection, am I right? All right, Larry, you better be worth it. It's a very pretty game. I really do love the music in this game. I would love to be able to hear that sheet music. Okay, here we go. North, north, east, east, north. Okay, we got it, we got it. It probably helps if I learn my east from my west. Alright, I'm already starting to get dried out. I hope that little wrong turn didn't mess with me. East, east. I like how the music also changes the more slumped over you get, because now I'm like, oh, I'm gonna die. Oh crap, I lost my place. I think I'm okay. Alright, let's go. Keep on. I think it's east. This may end horribly, folks. No, the other east, Patty. East is this way. Oh, there she goes. On her hands and knees now.
and the music gets a little bit more desperate, but I think we can survive until we get on our knees, like a few screens. But let's drink our water now so we don't, you know, die. You briefly consider a conservative rationing plan for your precious water, but oh, what the hell? Instead, you chug-a-lug the entire liter. Boy, you didn't realize how thirsty you were. Blindly celebrating in your thirst-crazed delirium, you throw the now-empty wine bottle far into the bamboo thicket and protest a bottle bill laws everywhere. Boop! And then we're back. All right, I think I know where we are. North? And I think I go west next? Let's just try this again, shall we? I'll be all right. All right, I made a little map, and I think we're in the home stretch. I think this is the exit right here. Please, for the love of God, don't want to do that again. Yeah! As you stumble out of the bamboo forest, you find yourself beside a beautiful stream. Lovely. All right, I think we're finally making good progress. So with the bamboo thicket behind us and the plot thickening as much as the bamboo was, let's call it a part there, and then we will continue on as Passionate Patty to try to find Leisure Suit Larry, the love of my life, who I let slip through my fingers because I muttered somebody else's name and Larry got all butthurt. But anyway, I think we made excellent progress. So I will see all you guys next time. And as always, good night, jelly beans. Good night.